So you're a small business owner and you want your website to look professional, to represent your business, yet you have no idea about how to code, how to do styles or design. All you want is just to be able to bring in new customers, new visitors, and have a website that represents you that you can update from time to time. And then you hear that having a free website isn't a really good representation of your business. Maybe you've tried Facebook in the past and people have been disappointed that even though you keep it up to date, they say it's not a fair representation of a professional business. You've also heard about WordPress, that over 40% of businesses are using WordPress, and yet that seems to be free. And others would say, well, yeah, but it's just a blogging platform. Why would you want to use WordPress? So back to the question, is WordPress easy to use? Is it ideal for beginners? Should you use WordPress for your business today? So if you're here for the first time, then a real warm welcome to Zanet Design. I've been designing websites for over 22 years. I use CMSs, that's content management systems, in the past. I've run a design team that have used CMSs as well, and I've used WordPress for about 18 years. So if you want to gain from my experience as a web designer, then make sure you subscribe and give a like to this video. If you want a quick answer to whether or not WordPress is ideal for you, the answer actually is yes. Even as a beginner, it has flexibility. Even though it's a CMS that started off as a blogging platform, WordPress is relatively easy to use for beginners. But if you asked me that question about a month ago, before version 5.9, I may have said no. And the reason being is that WordPress has made some incredible updates just in the last couple of weeks that I think now get it above the Shopify's, the Squarespaces, the Wix. In fact, we'll come on to in a moment why you might want to consider them, but why WordPress 5.9 is exceptionally better. In a sense, it has some extra additional things that have just been added that I think makes it ideal for beginners. Of course, if you were to ask other business owners whether they feel WordPress is easy for beginners, it will divide opinion. So if you have an opinion, if you've used Shopify, Wix, whether you've used WordPress in the past, put a comment down below and let me know whether you think it's easy for beginners and what you currently use. But of course, how do you define beginners? If I was to go down to my local library, there I'd see some beginners learning how to use a mouse on a laptop. So people come in at different levels. And of course, someone who can't even use a mouse isn't going to be able to find WordPress easy. But if you're wanting to avoid the coding aspect of it, building plugins, adding design ideas and CSS, then I'd say WordPress has now got to the stage where it literally is a drag and drop platform. And as you know, this is a question people have been asking for many years. Here I've got an email come through speaking about, is WordPress really simple? What is WordPress? Is creating websites with WordPress easy? How can I use WordPress as a beginner? People have been asking this question for years. Well, the answer to all of them now is I think it's just changed enough for beginners to be happy with 5.9. Now there are three types of entry levels with WordPress, but before we just touch on those, let's just consider the other alternatives that you may have used and you may still be using. Google Business Profile does provide a free website. And I would just say enable it anyway, because that will enhance your WordPress website. And you'll be able to integrate some points that we'll come onto in a moment of how you integrate Google Business Profile with a WordPress website. But the free website isn't going to turn heads, and it certainly won't take you to the next level. Shopify is another one that you may consider, and it's ideal if you want to run a business online. Has a steep learning curve, and that could be an ideal option if you're just wanting to sell things online. It's ideal for those businesses that just want to process payments and then sell products and then ship them out. Wix is another alternative you may look at, and that's again a nice drag and drop system, easy to use. Takes a little bit of effort to set up, but once it's set up, it's quite adaptable. But there are some hidden costs along the way. And I think it has a few limitations. And Squarespace, again, similar to Wix really, not always adaptable in the areas that you want, but it'll be ideal if you just want to go another level from, say, Facebook. But now let's come on to WordPress. Why is WordPress ideal? Why is it ideal for beginners? Well, it comes in three flavors. And as you can see here, we've got a choice here, WordPress.com, which is just a case of handling things their end. So you can add a custom domain. But on the whole, this is just a bit more of a blogging platform online on their servers. It has limitations. You won't be able to make it quite as customized as you'd like. WordPress.com for business, well, there'll be a cost here, because if you click on Start with Business, you'll see it starts off free, but then you can gradually go up to Premium and the Business one there as well. So those are kind of a couple of alternatives if you want them to host it. Of course, if you want to do your own hosting, then it gives you a lot more options to upgrade as and when you need to. And so I'd recommend downloading from WordPress.org. This is where you can optimize it. And the reason being is that once you've got your site up and running, you can have it the way you want. All plugins, all support, everything itself is really well supported. There's great forums out there, and I would recommend you have a go at WordPress.org, installing it yourself or getting someone just to get it up and running for you. But many of the hosting providers will offer the opportunity to upload it and set it up for you. So that's part of the package. You just click literally once and it installs itself. But the nice thing with WordPress is it pretty much is free. Whether you install it yourself or whether you have it on their servers, WordPress itself is a free open source platform. So why is 5.9 the yes answer to this question and 5.8 was maybe a no? Well, 5.9 brings along a lot of additional extras. We know the expression that Rome wasn't built in a day, and WordPress has taken 18 years to get to this point. And actually, credit to Wix, Shopify, Squarespace, I think they've pushed and they've made it so that WordPress has to go this way, unless it will lose being the top platform for businesses. WordPress has had consistent growth. Now it's saying about 43% of businesses and large corporations are using WordPress. The majority of WordPress users don't have any skills when it comes to design or even down to just coding HTML, CSS, JavaScript. All those things aren't needed because WordPress does all that for you. It literally is a case of installing plugins, finding a theme that you're comfortable with, and then literally just making some choices of what colors you want to use, what fonts you want to use. But these are drag and drop type of choices. And the reason why WordPress 5.9 is so useful is because it now does the drag and drop, it does the organization of the content, it does it seamlessly. So now when you click on blocks, you can just drag them around, you can click on a list, and it shows again how you can just move things around. But notice it doesn't jump around like it used to. And also it's very, very editable. So if you've ever used, say, a Word document and you've gone there and you've wanted to change a bit of text, a couple of fonts, add a couple of headings, maybe put a couple of images in. If you can use Microsoft Word, then you can use WordPress. It's got to that level now where all you need to do is make the changes, drag things around, add extra additional functionality if it's needed in those areas, press update, and it go all preview beforehand, and then it goes live. And that is it, you've updated your website. It works within themes itself, it works within templates, and unless you want a bespoke template, obviously then you get someone to design it for you, but it comes with thousands and thousands of templates, and you can even purchase one or two. They come at a very small price. WordPress 5.9 is very different to all the previous WordPresses, so my recommendation would be to try that today. Give it a go and see how you get on. But there is one other thing about WordPress that's absolutely crucial to bear in mind. You can integrate it with Google Business Profile. Now you'll know from this channel that Google Business Profile is a great way to optimize search engine optimization, get local business to come in. And you can have things like Google Maps integrated into your website as you want it to be. You can have your reviews when they go live and when people update Google Business Profile and you get a good review, you can have that showing on your website, on your footer, on various pages. Now, wouldn't it be great if you could see how you could do that if you do have a WordPress website? Well, I produced a video that shows you how you can do that for free and get all your great reviews showing on your WordPress website. So if you want to find out how to do that, then meet me on this video and I'll show you how to do it today.